With the introduction of mission specialists during the shuttle program, scientists were able to conduct research on the effects of microgravity on plants, animals, and even the human body. Through this research, we've found that one of the greatest challenges in keeping astronauts healthy is preventing bone loss. Preventing loss of bone density and microgravity will continue to be a challenge for astronauts in the future as they spend longer durations in space.
Hi, I'm Chloe, and I want to see how a loss of density affects our bones. We know astronauts can lose bone density because they don't have the pull of gravity putting stress on their bodies. For this, I have some corn puff cereal and plastic snack bags. Smaller bags make this easier. First, I'm going to fill up this bag and count how many pieces of cereal it takes to fill it up. I'm going to label this bag as a 0% bone loss, like a normal bone. Next, I'm going to calculate 60% of that total and put that many pieces of cereal into the second bag. This represents a 40% bone loss. Finally, I'm going to calculate 40% of the original bag and put that many pieces of cereal in. I'll label this bag as a 60% bone loss. Be sure the bag seals completely or you will have a mess. Now, it's time to see what happens to these bones when they are exposed to a sudden force. For this, we are going to put a big book on top and apply a sudden force. I'm going to repeat this for each bag. To calculate this, I divide the number of affected pieces in each bag, divide it by the original number in the bag, and multiply by 100. That will give me the percentage of the bone that was affected. You can see that the more bone loss, the more bone is affected by a sudden jolt. That's why exercise is so important on long space flights. Bone density loss can have serious effects on astronauts when they are reintroduced to Earth's gravity.
On the shuttle, to prevent bone density loss, astronauts used resistance bikes and other specially made exercise equipment. What's your favorite exercise? How do you think it would work in microgravity? Let us know down in the comments section. If you like this video, be sure to follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.